England. I come from the south, which is Portsmouth. I was brought up there for all my life, and I had the most comfortable upbringing. It was full of love. Being a woman in the UK, especially like a white British, there's a lot of freedom I personally have. There's no restriction on any religion. I'm a Catholic, so I can dress the way I want to, the way I feel the most comfortable. And with my personality, I was always I was outgoing as a child, but I would always dress as a certain way. And although people didn't necessarily agree with it, I wasn't the typical girl that you see. I was always someone who dressed very tomboyish, someone who, as growing up, I would prefer to dress more male and be comfortable with who I am. And I know that other cultures don't necessarily have that. They have strict rules, but we didn't. We could virtually do what we want, how we dress, and there'd be no limitations throughout school, church, and family life. Like I said, I wasn't the typical girl. And because I would dress this way, because I would act in this way and be around sport a lot and boys, people would often view me differently. They would not view me as the girl that they should be, that all the other girls in my year were. And a guy would come up to me and say, ask me out, and have those flirty relationships that they would with a girl, a typical girl who was in a skirt, who was full of makeup. I never had that. I just wanted to blend in. I wanted to just have fun. And I think me having fun when I was at that age kind of took away the element that I was actually trying to grow up, trying to be a woman. I wasn't following the way that other women were supposed to be growing up. And I think that's the image that people create, is that you have to be a certain way. And even British culture is not strict, but they do create a social identity that even is portrayed through social media as well, that you have to wear a skirt, you have to have long blonde hair, you have to act in a certain way, it's feminine. But I never did that at all. And in that way, I don't think men would look at me. And growing up, even I have some best friends who are guys, they will never view me as like a relationship potential, because they've seen me act in the way they do, just blend in, I guess, with everyone else. So they know, even if I'm changing now, even if university's changing how I act, it's still not the way they would view, because I've actually spent years with them growing up like a boy, I guess. In terms of fairness, I don't think that the image society has created of a man and a woman in a red dress with heels on, doing, you know, all the work, all the cooking, and that is something that, in terms of a feminist, I would say that it's just not how society actually is. Society should be viewed, and society should actually be created in a way that women dress how they want to and women act how they want to. And if men don't like that, then men should learn that actually since the 1950s we are changing, and it is gradually getting better. Like, in my opinion, it's gradually, we're seeing more women go outside the roles, like being a footballer or being in the army, and we see the way that they are viewed is changing as well, and they have a stronger opinion now than they did. They're not as oppressed as they were back then, but we're still at a point where there is that image that there is a man in smart clothes, there's a woman in a red dress, and that is how it should be.